President Trump just minutes ago. He just cannot let it go. He continues to attack a dead man, war hero Senator John McCain. Moments ago, speaking at a tank factory in Ohio, the president going off unprompted on the late Senator McCain, who passed away in August 2018, whose family is still grieving, blaming McCain for Middle East wars, blaming McCain for not being strong on veterans issues, blaming McCain for the Steele dossier ending up in the hands of the FBI, attacking McCain for not voting to repeal Obamacare, and even complaining that he didn't get a thank you for allowing John McCain's funeral to go forward.
I've never liked him much. Hasn't been for me. I've really probably never will. I endorsed him at his request, and I gave him the kind of funeral that he wanted, which as president, I had to approve. I don't care about this. I didn't get thank you. That's okay.
Even before this latest attack from President Trump, some Republicans were finally saying enough. Republican Senator Johnny Isaacson even promising to deliver a, quote, whipping of President Trump. Let's talk about all of this with my panel. Kevin Madden, this is going on multiple days now. McCain's been dead for 7 months. Why? Who does this help? Does this continue to get the base riled up? And where are Republican leaders?
I don't know why he's doing it. It's so gratuitous. And to your other question, it's in service of nothing. That's why it doesn't make any sense. And, you know, I think that the Republican leaders, more Republican leaders are going to come out, particularly as it becomes this character question for them on whether or not they're going to stand up for a deceased war hero. Not just a dead man, a deceased war hero who gave so much of his life and his service to this country. So more and more will have to come out because it will, I think, continue to be a question of where they stand on a key character question.
What we have seen is we did see your former boss, Senator Mitt Romney, say he doesn't understand why the president does this. But generally speaking, Republicans who have said anything have praised McCain, but not said anything about the president.
And this idea that, like, the base, this will rally the base. No, I mean, the base will always be there with the president for other reasons. But look, the president right now is actually at some peak approval ratings. He's got a 42% approval rating, which is actually one of his highest.
Including for the economy, 71%.
On the economy, he's got 90% approval with Republicans. This will have an impact. It will, because I think the larger American public, the people who are soft supporters of the president, who may not have voted for him, but they believe he's done a couple of good things, this is the type of thing that then drives them away and puts them into that position of saying, I can't stand by this.
At the same time, I think that's what senators, Republican senators, are looking at, is his approval rating, which is, I think, the point you're making. And they are fearful of that. I think a lot of Republican senators, if you were to talk to them behind closed doors, would be outraged by what President Trump is saying about John McCain. But even Senator Isaacson, I mean, there's been a little bit of a preview about his whipping or whatever he's calling it. And it's more like a light ribbing than really being harsh on it. He's not even calling President Trump out harshly on it. He's kind of talking around it. So this is a reflection of Republicans being fearful of Trump's base and what it means for them.
Here's what Senator Johnny Isaacson from Georgia said. Quote, the country deserves better. The McCain family deserves better. I don't care if he's president of the United States, owns all the real estate in New York, or is building the greatest immigration system in the world. Nothing is more important than the integrity of the country and those who fought and risked their lives for all of us. And still, he continues to do this. Isaacson issued that statement before Trump went off again.
Yeah, I mean, I think Kevin's right. There's no strategic reason why the president's doing this. I don't think he's doing it because it's a politically calculated move to rally his base. I think deep down inside, he covets the way that people in America think about and talk about John McCain, that he is revered as someone who did enormous good for his country. And I think that Trump wishes people would say those sorts of things about him. And I think he just doesn't understand why he doesn't get that kind of credit and praise, and just, as you said, can't let it go.
But the scary thing is, it's not just his rhetoric, it's also his policy. I mean, he's weakened military lending practices at the CFPB. He continuously says these asinine, ridiculous things. And personally, I feel like every time he says this, it's a challenge to his base. Isaacson said the country deserves better than this. The country deserves better than the Republican Party right now. They continue to let this president destroy core Democratic principles of the country, and yet nobody says anything. And to your point, all of these comments that have come out, they absolutely don't directly criticize the president. It's all just like the president doesn't mince words, but the Republican Party is. And they don't work for the president of the United States. They work for their constituents. So I think they can't fear them. They have to serve them and do the business of the American people. And the president's policies frequently run contrary to that.
A combat veteran I know texted me just out of the blue saying that the comments that the president makes about McCain hurt his soul. Where is the Republican leadership? Here's the Republican leadership. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell tweeted today, "Today and every day I miss my good friend John McCain. It was a blessing to serve alongside a rare patriot and genuine American hero in the Senate. His memory continues to remind me every day that our nation is sustained by the sacrifices of heroes." If it was your dad, would that be enough for you, Kevin? I'll say it wouldn't be enough for me if I were Meghan McCain. I understand why Meghan McCain's so upset about Republicans not speaking.
Yeah, and I mean, the very idea that you have to issue a statement like that is again, another challenge to the norms that we're used to. But also just the politicization of the memory of Senator McCain is just so tawdry. He ought to be always remembered for what he gave to this country, Republicans and Democrats. I mean, it went beyond party. It was about in service of country and greater ideals of the country and that he stood for. And that's what we should all be remembering, not watching this litigated on, you know, campaign rally, on the stage at a campaign rally, and even having to have this conversation.
Yeah, and, you know, Kellyanne Conway always says, whenever asked to respond to criticism that President Trump is doling out, including to her husband, mm-hmm. we'll get to that later in the show, mm-hmm. always says, well, he's a great counterpuncher. McCain has been dead since August. This isn't a counterpunch. McCain's not throwing any punches.
You know, and I have, among many people, a huge admiration for how Meghan McCain has handled this, and that she has said, if her dad were alive today, or, you know, he'd be laughing about the fact that he is driving Twitter today, and he is, you know, people are defending his memory. You know, I think one of the things that President Trump just said from the event he's at is pretty telling, which is where he's talking about McCain giving the dossier to the FBI. And, you know, as we've, you know, I think there isn't political strategy here, but this is in his gut, and he's angry about anyone who had a role in the Mueller investigation, which he knows is coming to a conclusion at some point, and it is already reflecting very poorly on his presidency.
So John McCain is not here to defend himself. Here's Meghan McCain, who does a pretty good job.
I think if I had told my dad, 7 months after you're dead, you're going to be dominating the news and all over Twitter, he would think it was hilarious that our president was so jealous of him mm-hmm. that he was dominating the news cycle in death as well. Do not feel bad for me and my family. We are blessed. We are a family of privilege. Feel bad for people out there who are being bullied that don't have support, mm-hmm. that don't have women of the View to come out and support their family. There are kids committing suicide mm-hmm. because of cyberbullying online. Mm-hmm. Yeah. There are people going through rough times. There are veterans who come back. We have 20 veterans a day committing mm-hmm. suicide. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Focus on these issues. Yeah. These are the issues I beg the White House to pay attention to. Yeah. I'm just surprised because I do think this is a new bizarre low. Yeah. I will say mm-hmm. attacking someone who isn't here is a bizarre low.
She's putting a brave face on, but let's be honest, this is very difficult for their family, including for their sons, who I believe are in harm's way. They're both in the military.
Yeah, and you know, she's saying that her dad would find it hilarious. Unfortunately, the rest of the country doesn't. When you have people in the Republican Party who stand by and don't call out this behavior for what it is, that's not a political party, that's a cult. And people have to start addressing the real issue, which is this president. It's not just his rhetoric, it's his actual policies that go along with it. And when you have people who are willing to stand by and let this happen and not address the real issue at hand, I think you'll continue to see this kind of rhetoric, because the scary thing isn't what he says, it's how his base responds. They applaud this, they cheer this on, they laugh about it. And that's not what our country stands for. It's not what it should be.
And we should note that this is not the first Gold Star family that President Trump has attacked. Remember the Khans, who came out and spoke against him in the Democratic National Convention in 2016. Their son, I believe his name was Khazir Khan, was killed in Iraq. Senator McCain, in fact, spoke at that time in 2016. It's time for Donald Trump to set the example for our country and the future of the Republican Party. While our party has bestowed upon him the nomination, it is not accompanied by unfettered license to defame those who are the best among us.
Yeah, I mean, this is who Donald Trump is, right? This is his style. This is how he approaches politics. This is how he approaches public life. And I actually think that that's part of the reason why you're not seeing more Republicans put out statements, because I think within the Republican Party, among those who behind closed doors go, I can't believe that this is happening again, there's a sense that one more press release and one more, Mr. President, I wish you wouldn't say that, is just not going to change who he is or how he presents himself to the American people. He's got a formula. He is who he is. He thinks that it's a winning formula. And I think most Republicans who wish that he would change course are sort of resigned to the idea that there is no press release, there is no conversation they can have with him that is going to get him to stop being the man that he is.
I want to correct myself, because your con was the father in the Gold Star family. I'm sorry, I was going by my faulty old memory. I will say one thing just about this before we take a quick break, and that is I totally understand that, but, well, Kevin and I are old enough to know that we're here. Presidents come. They're here for 4 years or 8 years, then they leave. We're still here. You guys will be there, too. Members of Congress are still here.
Right.
So long after the indecent remarks of Donald Trump, these politicians are likely going to still have to be here. Mm-hmm. And we're all paying attention. Mm-hmm. We're all paying attention as to who is saying things and who isn't saying things. And some of us can sleep at night and some of us can't.